Hello students, good afternoon. Welcome back to our IT section, Standard 4. Chapter 5, Microsoft Word 2007. So students, in previous chapter, we had learned working with Windows. So today we are going to learn Microsoft Word 2007. We shall now learn some more features of MS Word program. The MS Word is one of the most popular programs used for word processing and documentation purposes. MS Word is a part of MS Office, which includes more programs apart from just word processing. MS Office includes four main components. They are MS Word for word processing, MS Excel for spreadsheet, MS Access for database management, and MS PowerPoint for presentation purposes. However, we will limit ourselves to MS Word only in this chapter, and we shall learn MS PowerPoint in the next chapter. So, MS Word is an excellent software among any of other word processing softwares, as it allows not only to type text, letters, stories, poems, etc., but it has many tools to enhance the look at the content type on the document by applying the various fonts and inserting images. You can check any rectify spelling and grammar mistakes quickly. Let us understand some more important features of MS Word. The features of MS Word. First, the MS Word allows you to create a document, save it, and print any number of copies you want. Second, it allows you to change the font style and font size through artistic letters. Third, spelling and grammar mistakes can be checked and corrected instantly while typing the document. Fourth, pictures and images can be inserted through cliparts and other applications. Fifth, you can insert data in a table format. And sixth, MS Word allows you to enhance the look of the document by using various options of border and shading. So, we have already learned how to create, open and save documents in MS Word. So, let us do a quick recap and then understand some of the uses of more tools in details. First, starting MS Word 2007. Steps to open Microsoft Word. First, click on the Start button. Second, click on the All Programs option. Third, click on Microsoft Office. And fourth, click on Microsoft Office Word 2007. Then, the Microsoft Office window screen has appeared on the screen. See, this is the various tools in the Microsoft Office Word window 2007. So students, we will see the components of MS Word window 2007. First is the Office button. The Office button is a round button on the topmost left corner of the window, which Microsoft Office logo on it. It includes options similar to the options on File menu in the earlier versions of Microsoft Word. Second, the title bar. The title bar is the topmost bar at the Microsoft Word window. It displays the name of the program, the Microsoft Word, and the name of the current document which you are working on. Third, ribbon. The ribbon is located at the top of Word window and has various tools used to adjust the appearance of a link in a document. Next, quick access toolbar. This is displayed on the top left of the window. It shows the options like save, undo and redo. You can add or remove any commands from this toolbar by just right clicking on the command in the ribbon and selecting add to access quick access toolbar. You can also remove the command when not required. As the name suggests, it allows easy use of the options or commands. Next is a ruler bar. The ruler bar allows you to format the vertical alignment of text in a document. Next is a status bar. The status bar displays information about the currently active document. This includes the page number that you are working, the column and line, number of the cursor, position and so on. Next is a scroll bar. The scroll bar helps you scroll the contents of the document. You can do so by moving the elevator button along the scroll bar or by clicking on the buttons with the arrow mark on them to move up and down and left and right of a page. The bar which moves the page up and down is called vertical scroll bar, and which moves the page left and right is called horizontal scroll bar. Next is a workspace. The workspace is the area in the document window where you enter, type the text. Now we will see creating a new document. Steps to create a new document. First, open MS Word. Second, click on the Office button. Third, click on the new option. The new dialog box appears on the screen. Fourth, select the blank document. And fifth, click on the OK option. Next is the typing text and paragraph. A paragraph is a portion of the text typed continuously without pressing the enter key. When you press the enter key, the insertion point will jump to the new line and a new paragraph will start. Open blank new document and type the paragraph like this, the inner planets paragraph and the outer planets paragraph. So, save the documents on the desktop and name it as planets. To format any text, you need to select it first. To select text, it is important to select the text before using any tools to format the text. However, there are different ways to select text. A select text is always highlighted on the screen. First, to select a word, double click on the word in quick succession. Second, to select a few lines of text and place the cursor before the first letter of the word or paragraph you want to select, and then click and drag the mouse over the text. Next is the making text bold, underline and italics. The options of bold, italics and underline are similar to those on WordPad. It helps to highlight the title or a particular word or sentence. In the above paragraph, make the titles the inner planets and the outer planets. Bold, italic and underline. First the select title, the inner planets. Second, the click the bold option, its short form is B, on the home menu tab of the ribbon. Third, the click on italic option, its short form is I. And fourth, the click on underline option, its short form is U. The title has been highlighted. Similarly, follow the steps to make the next title bold, italic and underline. See, the title, The Outer Planet, has now been highlighted. Next is a capitalizing text after typing. The capitalize each word of the two titles, the inner planets and the outer planets. First, select the words, the inner planets. Second, then click on the change case option on the ribbon. Third, a list of options appears. Fourth, select the options of capitalize each word. And repeat the same steps for the title, The Outer Planets. Understood? Okay, next is a changing font style. Open the file Planets, which you have saved on the desktop. Change the font style of the title, The Inner Planets. First, select the title, The Inner Planets. Second, click on the font option to get a drop down list of font styles. Third, choose a font style. Fourth, click on Calibri or Arial or Times Roman. Alternatively, you can select a font that makes the title look attractive. Next is a changing font size. To change the font size of the title, The Outer Planets. To select the title, The Outer Planets, click on the option for font size. Then click on the 22 or select any other size of your choice. Next is a changing font color. To change the font color of the title, The Inner Planets, and second the title, Outer Planets, to blue color and select the title, The Inner Planets. First, click on the font color option. You will get a drop down list of colors. Second, click on blue color. The title would now reappear blue in color. Follow the same steps to color the second title, The Outer Planets. Understood? Next is a bullets and numbering. Type the following using bullets and numbering options in the ribbon. Type the text. First Mercury, second Venus, third Earth, fourth Mars, fifth Jupiter, sixth Saturn, seventh Uranus and eighth Neptune. Now select the text. Then click on bullets and numbering on the ribbon. Then select the desired bullets from the options and the text now appears as follows. First using the numbering. Example, 1 number Mercury, 2 number Venus, 3 number Earth and 4 number Mars. Now using the bullets. Example, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. Understood? Yes. Next is a saving a document. The steps to save a document. First, click on the Office button. Second, click on the Save As option. The Save As box appears. Third, select the location. For example, desktop. From the Save in drop-down list box. Fourth, type the name of the file, example Planets, in the text box provided beside the file name. Fifth, click on the Save option. Understood? Next is a opening an existing document. Steps to open an existing document. Click on Office button. Second, click on Open option. The Open dialog box appears. Third, select the location where your file had been saved earlier from the drop-down list box, for example, desktop. And fourth, select the file you want to open, for example, planets. Fifth, click the open button on the right corner of the window. Understood? Next is a closing a document. Steps to close a document. First, click on Office button. Second, click on the Close option. The current active document is closed, but the MS Word window is still open. Next is the existing MS Word. Steps to exit MS Word. First, click on the Office button. Second, click on the Exit Word button. Alternatively, you can use the different method. First, click the Close button on the right side of the title bar of Microsoft Windows. See, like this. So, students, everyone have understood this chapter? So, students, tell me the components of MS Word Windows 2007. Yes, first is the Office button. Second, title bar. Third, ribbon. Fourth, quick access toolbar. Fifth, ruler bar. Sixth, status bar. Seventh, scroll bar. And eighth, workspace. Very good. So students, I hope everyone have understood this chapter, Microsoft Word 2007. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.